everyone! I'm really excited to introduce this new video series called FD Paints, where I'll be challenging myself to upload several speed painting videos to practice my painting and illustration skills while discussing topics that will help you grow as an artist. Today's episode features this piece called Anna Blue, part of the Melting Girl collection of paintings I made, where one feature item melts. So in Anna Blue's case, it's her hair. Now, this collection uses a combination of watercolor and acrylic paint. Watercolor for the girls and acrylic for the background and melting feature. Each of the original pieces in this video series will be available as prints for purchase in the near future. Yay! I'm still in the process of putting that together on top of all the other crazy things I've set out to do since restarting this channel. So let's get started with today's topic of discussion. How to teach yourself to draw and paint. So I'm actually a self-taught artist, which means that I never went to art school or had a professional art education. But like most of you, I did develop an interest in art from a young age and have been drawing since. So of course I did do a lot of research on how to draw, how to paint, and even till now I'd watch videos on YouTube and found them to be super helpful. So I thought I'd do the same to help those of you who are looking to teach yourself as well. Let's start with materials. My first tip for you is to get yourself a sketchbook. It means so much more than a pile of papers. It's almost like a psychological thing. You have a place to go to draw. And the thing is, it doesn't need to be masterpieces in every page. It's just a place for you to practice your drawing. So choose a theme for every page. I've had so many sketchbooks over the years and it's kind of funny to look back at them, but you know what? I felt more proud than anything else. So when you finish that book, I guarantee that you are going to feel super accomplished regardless of what's in it. Now we're going to move on to the fundamentals of art, which is actually something that not a lot of people know of in the first place, considering that a lot of us are self-taught artists. But I learned this watching YouTube videos. So number one is perception. Draw what you see in front of you rather than drawing the symbols you see in your head. For example, eyes. It's not just a dot inside of a circle, but actually try to draw what you see when you look at an eye. The eyelash, the pattern inside of the iris, the eyelid. There's a lot more to it than meets the eye. Number two, construction. Instead of drawing outlines of an object, construct it using shapes so you can understand the structure of what you're drawing. So instead of drawing the outline of a sausage dog, draw the shapes that make up that sausage dog. If you Google drawing fundamentals construction, a lot of useful images would pop up that you can use to get a better idea of what you need to do. And that'll make it easier for you to draw it again next time from memory. Number three, gestures. Practice gestures and figure drawing so you can capture how humans interact with each other. So instead of your character standing awkwardly, what gesture would it do if it was happy or sad or sassy? That's a fun place to experiment. Number four, anatomy. By putting everything before this together, it would be easier for you to draw the human anatomy. Hands were my worst nightmare. It just took me so long to go from 5 sausages to 5 fingers. It's not going to be perfect the first time, but keep at it and I promise you it will get better. Number five is color theory, the fun part. Observe nature. Look at the gradient of colors that happen at sunset. How many of you actually look at the colors of the sky throughout the day? It can be pretty therapeutic. Study your favorite photos, your favorite art. Might even give you ideas for your own work. Number six is rendering, or shading. The act of painting and making something look like a form. Try to think through each stroke that you do. Think about shadows and highlights. Start from lighter shades and slowly build on it. Number seven is perspective. Being able to represent a three-dimensional object, including characters in that space. And last but not least, composition. The arrangement of the image. It's organizing how a viewer sees the painting or drawing, the flow of how the viewer's eye moves from one object to another. It's also arranging the image, so if things aren't too close or too far apart. Those are all the fundamentals of art. Yay, you did it! Now you know the fundamentals of art, even if you hadn't picked up a pencil before. Now you know better than some people who already have. My next tip for you is to remember this. art is a form of expression, and when you fully understand that, it can be so liberating. A lot of my philosophy with music and art comes down to a mixture of those two things: having strong fundamentals, but then also being able to incorporate your own style, your own flavor, your own expression. Don't feel like you need to limit yourself to the idea of what it should be like once you're ready to spread your wings and fly. Which is why I study opera but sing pop. Which is why this little lady here is purple and blue and yellow with a hint of Asian. Now, with every new skill, you'd want to develop the right mindset to go with it. So a few mental things to take note of. Persistence. Even if you feel like you're bad today, I promise the more you do it, even if you take breaks in between, it will get better. And you will get better each time. Everything that I do, it took time. I took breaks. I got tired of drawing. I played music. I got tired of music. I danced. But you just gotta always come back to it and try again. Number two is privacy. Make sure that you're doing this for you. Finish that sketchbook before you share it. Make sure your motivation is intrinsic. That way you will get better regardless of the reward. And lastly, forgiveness. It's okay if it's not perfect. It's okay if it still looks like sausages instead of fingers. And yes, it's going to take time, so don't be hard on yourself. That's pretty much it. If you're looking for something to do other than the usual things you already do, I recommend you try it out. Doesn't matter if you're 14 or 40, if you're interested in it, just try and give it a go. And if you say to yourself, I just don't have the time, you'd be surprised at what you can do in just 15 minutes. So if you can find 15 minutes to yourself, pick up a pencil and off you go. It's obviously not easy. If it was easy, everyone would be doing it. And it wouldn't make people go, wow, that's pretty cool. So keep at it, and I promise you it will most definitely be worth it. We are coming to an end to this video. As a thank you for watching this video, I'm offering discount coupons to those of you who is interested in purchasing my prints when it's ready in store. So just key in ANNABLUE20 at checkout. Keep a lookout for them at www.farahdiyanah.com. Okay, that's all for now. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe. It really does help my channel. Thank you so much for watching, and thanks for watching, you know, all of these videos that I've put up for the last few weeks. And see you next time. Bye!